I wonder what happens if you exhaust your supply.
You hear a shout, echo on the wind, a standard fall greeting. A caravan of fall are heading your direction, probably a few hundred in total. You meet them halfway.
Hello, boys. Nice weather to be riding a caravan, don't you think?
You must be with Wagner.
Was. Wagner didn't make it.
You're serious? It's getting grim out here, but I didn't expect that.
You're flying the shield banner. What's happening? Isn't Ulfar in charge there?
I'm puzzled. Ulfar's still in shield. In case he needs to be, he sent me to meet Fognir. Well, you.
We've seen something happening in shield yet.
We've seen nothing happening in shield yet.
What do you mean?
No, Dredge. They never came through shield. They're all pouring out of Richhorn. We only just found out about it. One group went that way, we came here.
Richhorn? The fort on the bay? That place has been abandoned for hundreds of years.
Well, not anymore.
Yeah, maybe that's why they're there. By all accounts, it looks like another damned invasion.
Luden forces his way into the conversation.
God damn you, Luden. Wait a godless minute. What did you do?
Careful now.
You be careful. What did you start? You think men don't remember history? The long banner hangs in Erbarang.
The Second Great War nearly screwed us all. What did you do this time?
Who the fane is this?
Well, none of these are really in Luden's favor. I can say he's a nobody. I can say, take him and go to Grofheim, we'll meet you later. I can say, shut your mouth, Luden, or I'll smash your face in.
If I say, take him and go to Grofheim, do I also lose the archer girl?
Let's go for the second choice.
Are you insane? He just said an army of Dredge are pouring out of that fort.
Go on to Grofheim then, Prince. Having your blood on my hands would be worse than doing nothing.
This shuts Luden up for a moment. You can see the battle raging in his head. He looks desperate for safety. But he didn't expect to flee like a coward. He expected you to come along. He glances at his men.
We're already this far. If this is the Varl's doing, I'll know of it, and so will my father. Besides, you need my help and my fighters. If I go, so do Irsa and Bursi.
Luden's unexpected flip-flop catches you like a swift kick to the shins. Mohr can't contain a chuckle.
Ha! The prince has courage!
I can just knock him out cold, what? No, do whatever you like, Luden. I don't care.
Paint me the villain, Hakon. What do I care? I'm sick of you being the only one to do as he pleases in this alliance.
These are Varl lands. We're facing an army of Dredge. How much experience do you have in these matters?
True, mankind has never provoked them into a war. You're going for a third.
Is stunting the Dredge into genocide a game for your kind?
The game really wants me to punch this cocky prince.
But no, I'm going to walk away.
You curse and threaten pandemonium. The prince has chosen to be no responsibility of yours. If Luden stays, so do Fasold warriors. They join the caravan.
Well, everything went better than expected. I got a bunch of guys.
More finds you, this time in a hurry. I found out what's wrong with the sick Farrell, he says, clutching his gut. Ate some of it myself, he says. Food's not poisoned, but it's spoiled, bad fish, and getting more so. Ugh, wish I didn't just think about that.
Spoiled food? You must have got it from the merchant back near Vadrofal, he says. Mixed it in with the good stuff. Could have messed up as much as half our supply. What do you want to do?
Oh shit. Well,
I might find out what happens when you run out of supply.
Dump everything that could be unsafe. Away with this spoiled food. More Nords, pointing out that's a massive portion, and adds, I don't think they did it on purpose. For what it's worth, the tainted food is dust.
oh damn. The tainted food is tossed down a hill, where it won't attract attention.
More returns, saying take care of.
Taken care of, but we've got a lot of ill fighters, at least 40 at the moment. What do you want to do about them?
Tell them to avoid fighting until they recover. Tell them to tough it out. Send them back to Strand with an escort. Avoid fighting until they recover. I only need the freshest fighters.
Mogar goes to spread the word. Damned careless merchants. You hope this will be the end of it.
I hope this won't be the end of me and my army.
But it gave my morale a big boost. The hike approaching the Godstone is murder. You recall how most Godstones were built on hills overlooking other Godstones, so that travelers could follow them and find their way between cities. It does nothing to ease your pains.
Oh god! Dredge! Shouts Mogar near the front of the caravan. Suddenly black rocks are whizzing past your head. What the hell is this, you shout. Mogar shakes his head. A stone slams into the shield of a nearby Varrel, exploding in a flash of light and razor sharp fragments.
Get behind the shield banger, shouts Mogar, as you approach for a fight.
Goddammit, are they using explosives? Dredge line the battlefield, weapon drawn, a fight seems inevitable. You take a quick head count, there must be at least 629 of them. And 124 fighters and 625 Varrel at my side.
Okay, let's do this. Charge seemed to work, but let's go for... Hold them off.
You consider making a wall and skirting the battlefield, buying enough time for you to help the weak and the wounded make their escape. It's a risk. Your warriors will take the brunt of the attack, but it may save more lives in the long run. Get those shields up! Your forces are already wading into the fray as you assemble your allies and stay close to the caravan, ready to defend it. Enemies are starting to slip past the line and approach.
Oh, we got a new dude. Let's add him to the fray. And let's make Ursa join as well. Yes. Let's switch these guys up. Looks like my force is becoming more and more Varrel. But I mean, why wouldn't you fight with these big guys? What the hell is this? Ninjas? Why are there only two of them?
I don't trust this at all.
Oh, there's one here as well. There are three of them. I am absolutely blind. Yeah. Okay, I'm fine with this formation.
crap.
Well, that guy is dead. Oh, they are ranged.
But that isn't going to save him here.
Boom! Wait, what? Why did he move?
It wasn't his turn.
Look at this guy. Look at these guys just ranging it up.
Fossils, you're the new guy. What do you have? Malice. Taunt one adjacent unit, causing them to attack you on their next turn. Oh, so you're basically a tank. That's cool, I guess. Don't really need it now.
This is going to be a battle where I just end up running all over the map to catch these guys, but this guy is so dead. Whoa! Well, goddammit. Goddammit. Why are you so big, Varl?
Can you finish it with an arrow?
Oh, you cannot. But you can do some damage. There we go. How do you like it if people range at you? Not rage. And he's dead.
Provoker! You take a moment to survey the battlefield. The enemy is being pushed back all the way down the line.
Let's kill a few more as they flee this time, because I got pretty much a bunch of guys left. Let's go for it. You attack any dredge still brave enough to face you. It's just one guy? Yeah. This should prove to be fun.
Ah, yeah.
You're so dead. You're so dead. Yep. He is. Victory! 0 injuries. I feel like I'm getting better at this. Or maybe it's all in my mind. Who knows?
What in the depths are these? You wonder, looking at the unusual dredge slingers. Nobody knows. Without warning, a deranged and half-dead slag stumbles out of a brush, throwing itself upon the yaks attached to the treasure cart. What's a slag? Is that like a moose? surprised for our pull weapons. But not before the whole cart slides off slick rock and the sheer drop stopped suddenly by a low growl. The enormous metal wagon dangles precariously off a cliff. From the end swings a confused yox, still tied to its reins. On top, the dredge hang on tight. Keeping the whole thing from plummeting over the side is Gunnulf, one hand white-knuckling the cart, the other wrapped around a tree trunk. Let's go and help, Gunnulf. You grab the cart and pull. You barely make any ground when the tree he's holding onto tears from the ground, dragging you with terrifying force towards the earth. Shout for others to help and pull it back up. Come on, guys. Too late. The others lunge towards the cart just as it topples over the side. At the last moment, you let go, but Gunnulf does not. No! Gunnulf! No! Cries the old Varl. The cart plummets and flips over the rocks, along the way tossing its contents across the snow in a shower of gold and gore. The yox and the dredge are torn to shreds. Gunnulf lies motionless, his limbs splayed at unnatural angles. Following the shock of Gunnulf's death, you find yourself wondering why the dredge went after the yox in the first place. Then you realize the bigger problem is the vast fortune now laying at the bottom of the cliff.
Nothing for it, there is no time to stop now. Your call, Ubin. Try to cover it up and come back later. Leave some varl together and return to Strand. Try to recover Gunnulf's body. Goddammit. What are your thoughts on this, Ubin? What choice do we have, he mutters. Gunnulf is dead. Anyone can see that. Even if we could gather up the gold, we've got nothing to haul it. He sounds defeated, but resolute in moving on. You begrudgingly set off, leaving the grisly scene behind you.
God damn it. God fucking damn it. But that's it for me for today. Thank you for watching, and stay tuned for the next episode of the Banner Saga, where we find out what's going on at this Godstone and more mysteries unravel about the dredge. So yeah, see you guys later. Bye.